my view, the unrealistic belief that somehow that the Graham-Durbin bill was going to be the path forward without the president's signature, with a doubtful future in the House of Representatives, hopefully that's been set aside. I say that with great respect because I don't want to indicate or send any signal that I don't appreciate their concern or their passion or their effort to try to come up with a solution here. It's just that I think it should be clear to everyone that that is not going to be the path forward because of the circumstances I mentioned. The president doesn't support it, and it won't pass in the House of Representatives and even get to the president's desk. So we find ourselves here in a completely unnecessary situation. Our Democratic colleagues were pretty unanimous, with I guess four or five exceptions, in voting down a four-week continuing resolution and causing the government to shut down. The Majority Leader, Senator McConnell, has offered them another proposal, which was a three-week continuing resolution while we continue to do our other work. And they objected to voting on that last night, but the Majority Leader has now filed for cloture, which means that will ripen here tomorrow. And so they have a choice. They can keep the government shut down for another day before we vote on that, or we could agree to vote on it today and reopen the government while we continue our good faith negotiations and discussions about these other matters. But when the Democratic leader came to the floor and said he doesn't want to hurt the military and he doesn't want to hurt people who are suffering from opioid addiction, he doesn't want to hurt the veterans, he doesn't want to hurt people who are relying on the government for a pension, or people who are relying on the federal government for disaster relief, and so he objected to the continuing resolution and caused a government shutdown, I have to say that's a strange way of showing your devotion and your support for the military or veterans or opioid addicts or people who are depending on the federal government to come up with disaster relief. Shutting down the government helps none of them, none of them at all. And when he talks about continuing resolutions hurting the military, I agree with that. But the very thing that's hurting the military the most is the shutdown and the uncertainty. Our National Guard can't train, for example. So the solution to this long term is, or actually short term, it should be short term, is an agreement on spending caps. So the Appropriations Committee can come up with an appropriation bill that will fund the government through the end of September, through the end of the fiscal year. But what's really happened here, unfortunately, is our colleagues across the aisle have listened to the most extreme elements in their political party and shut down the government over an unrelated immigration issue that doesn't even ripen until March the 5th. Now, I say that just to say it doesn't have to be decided today, nor can it be decided today, but that's what they're trying to hold all the rest of this hostage in order to do. All across the country, the headlines reflect the reality. From the Associated Press, it reads, Senate Democrats derail bill to avert shutdown. And even the New York Times read, Senate Democrats block a bill to keep government open past midnight. And I can't help but share in the frustration of those who, in disgust, find us in a situation that we don't want to be in and that makes absolutely no sense to anybody. Because everything in the continuing resolution that our colleagues across the aisle voted against last night are things they support. It's support for the military. It's support for the opioid treatment. It's support for veterans. But they voted against it in order to hold all of that hostage to this unrelated issue of immigration. Well, the minority leader, my friend from New York, Senator Schumer, has done the best he can to try to spin the story and to try to explain his strategy and to cast blame. And I have to admire his talent. Senator Schumer is my friend. We've worked together on a number of items in a bipartisan way to come up with solutions to complicated issues. And he's a very talented and smart person, but not even he can come up with a credible story here for why he chose to lead this shutdown effort for the federal government, because it makes no sense whatsoever. And he does have my sympathy. He's the leader of a tough group of senators, including some radical members who are running for president and who've held the rest of their conference hostage and done them no good service, leading them down this box canyon only to find the government shut down. How do we know that this is their plan all along? Well, the Democratic whip, the senior senator from Illinois, laid out the strategy in the Washington Post last November. He said, Senator Richard Durbin of Illinois said he's encouraging his colleagues to join him in blocking spending legislation if the legal status of Dreamers is not resolved. That was last November. He was already plotting the shutdown we find ourselves in today for this unrelated issue that we are committed to working on a bipartisan basis. So the minority leader can't convince us or anybody that knows the facts that this is somehow President Trump's fault. This is their plan, something they've been plotting for a long time now. And now they find themselves in a position that not even they can explain how this helps the country or how this helps these young DACA recipients. It's not going to change anything for them to shut down the government. Matter of fact, I think it just polarizes people and makes things worse. Well, we're not going to let him hold health insurance for 9 million children hostage over an unrelated immigration issue. That's the Children's Health Insurance Program. This bill that they filibustered last night would reauthorize this program for the most vulnerable 9 million children in the country. For what? Well, they support that bill. It was voted out on a bipartisan basis out of the Senate Finance Committee, and they come to the Senate floor and they kill it. 9 million vulnerable children. And they support it. Strange way of showing it. Well, clearly the American people deserve better. Soon our colleagues across the aisle will have a chance to reopen the federal government, a chance to abandon this brinksmanship, which threatens the safety and security of the country. It threatens the very people we depend upon to defend us and their families, and it threatens the access to health care for 9 million vulnerable children. They need to fix this. They need to do the right thing for the American people, and they can do that today by agreeing to vote on this 3-week continuing resolution that will take us to February the 8th while we continue to work on this issue relating to DACA, the Deferred Action on Childhood Arrivals, what we talked about earlier. Or they can do it tomorrow and keep the government shut down for another 24 hours. My message to them is think about the men and women who put on the uniform of our country and deploy in dangerous locations around the globe to fight our nation's wars and to protect our homeland. Think about those who wake up in the morning and put on a badge and go out, possibly into harm's way, to protect our communities. And think about those 9 million children who depend on us for their health coverage. I hope, after having had a few hours of sleep last night and had a chance to think through this fundamentally flawed strategy, our colleagues will reconsider. Mr. President, the country deserves better.